John chapter 1 and verse 32. And John bore witness, saying, I saw the Spirit ascending. Can you see a spirit? Can you see the Spirit? Have you all ever thought about why then John is saying, why is he written like that? Who can see the Spirit? Cannot write. Cannot see the Spirit. If you can see the Spirit, then you can see God. There's no way we can see God. The closest we had was Jesus. And through the manifestation, through men. And the expressions that all creation carry. These are all the few ways for you to recognize the attributes of God, not the personally you meet God. Last week I also shared with them, have you seen the burning bush when Moses met? What was the burning bush? Have you really looked into the burning bush? What was God revealing? God consistently revealing what was in his mind. What not was, is in his mind. So what is the burning bush? What do you see in the burning bush? It's a bush, it's a plant, right? It's a plant. Plants symbolically always speak about what? Plants and trees speaks about humanity, us. And with fire. Fire speaks about the presence of God. But notice the plant was not consumed in the fire, it was not burned. So we're seeing a picture of the body of Christ, the church, in the glory of God. Burning bush. That's how I'm supposed to be to you now. That's how you're supposed to be to others. When people come and encounter you, what are they encountering? Moses encountering God through the burning bush. So everything God revealed always speaks about what is in the mind of God. What is in the mind of God? That we become the temple of God. That we will become the dwelling place of God. You understand that? So everything, there's a context to it, we have to look into it. So here you see that you can't see the Spirit, but he said, John bore witness, I saw the Spirit descending, look carefully, from heaven as a dove. See that? He did not see the Spirit of God. He did not see the Holy Spirit. இதோ இந்த நேரத்தில் பரிசுத்த ஆவியான மத்தியில் இருக்கிறார். எப்படியா சொல்றீங்க? எப்படி சொல்றீங்க? இதோ பரிசுத்த ஆவியான் அசைவாடுறது என் கண்ணால் பார்த்தங்கிறாங்க. பொய். Because that they using all these things to touch your psyche, to touch your soul, to touch your emotion, and then you imagine something is moving. All these are you can learn hypnotism. In the teaching, a lot of pastors are reading hypnotism, and that's how people fall down. Sometimes truly people fall because they can't understand the presence of God. Idhu unmada, but we don't use that to mimic an environment that God is moving. So you need to understand as the church, when here John say, I bore witness. What is that? I bore witness? John bore witness saying, I saw the Spirit. Now I've always been teaching you about seeing. There's two levels of seeing. One is your natural, the other one spiritual side. Spiritual side, when you learn to see spiritually, that's what you call faith. Anyone who say faith, I got faith, that means they're telling, I have spiritual sight to see the finished work of God. Faith has got to do with seeing what the finished work of God for mankind, for all creation. Okay, all this got Bible evidence, you must continue to hear. So I saw the Spirit, now listen, I saw the Spirit. He didn't say I saw a Spirit, literally a Spirit moving. Descending from heaven, what is descending from heaven? You need to tell that, where is this thing coming from? So descending from heaven means, heaven is the finished design, finished work of God. Supposedly to give, it was given to Adam to establish the earth. Heaven is the design for earth, which was given to Adam. Adam lost the right to it. That's why he quote the word heaven. It's very important because Adam, now Jesus, coming to the baptism. There he lost the rights. Here now the right is coming back again. What was given to him, he lost it, went back, the plan lingered. And now finally one faithful one comes and stands in the earth, qualified to receive a mandate from heaven. So John is, see, a lot of people get carried away, I saw the Spirit. Everyone, Christianity, we focus too much in woo, all the freaky stuff. We are not looking into the truth. I saw the Spirit descending from heaven. Now, like a dove. Like a dove. So now we come to the point. He saw in the spirit, witness a nature of God ascending, not a white dove. Not actually a white dove. Maybe you'll see like a dove. Why? Because every animal, every creation carries an expression of this unseen God. Say amen. Now you got to go and study a plant in your house. You may have a plant. You can have a parrot in your house. You can have a dog in your house. You can see, even a grasshopper can just come by your window. Observe it carefully. It speaks about a mystery that you and I can never understand. But we are too busy in this world. We don't have time. Sometimes we see some creatures just come and run into our life. We are chasing and we are panicking with all the wrong things. But everything carries the expressions of God. Amen. So, why there's a dove? Why did God create a dove? Every animal carries something we need to study. So a dove, like he saw in his mind, he saw a dove ascending. So what is the meaning? What is John saying? I saw the Spirit, the Father, descending from heaven, from the work which has been given, which has been taken, now bringing back. Finally, heaven can now ascend into the earth, first time. From heaven, like a dove. And he remained permanently upon him. So why dove? What is dove? Okay. The dove carries three peculiar, unique personality. There are more, you go and search. This is not a pigeon. Don't go and mix up with a pigeon. And a dove is a very highly honored, qualified, very dignified, very royal. The nature of a dove is beautiful. It's very high. That's why it doesn't come and stay in your house. It doesn't sit anywhere. But when it finds a place and sit down, they honor the place. You go and read about them. So I just share with you three things, which is the attribute of God found in a dove, now ascending upon Jesus, most important. Number one, a dove doesn't have a gallbladder. We all have a gall. When we eat, all the bitter, all the acidic, all the stuff will go. A dove doesn't have a gall. Gallbladder, they call it. There's only one in our church that doesn't have a gallbladder. That's Pastor Paul. He had it removed because he had some problem. Or maybe he's very pure. He's the only one in our church who don't have a gallbladder. Anyone want to experience God, go to him. Okay? What is the gall for? Gall carries the bitterness. For us, it's acid in our body which destroys. They don't carry bitterness. The word is, they can't carry bitterness. They don't have something in them to have bitterness. It's pure. Right? One. Go read about it. The other one is, they are single focused. We have two eyes. Right? If you close this eye, you see something. And you see this eye, you will see another side. See this side? For this dove, either way, both eyes will see one picture. Speaks about the position of Jesus to see as the Father sees. He cannot see anything apart from Christ. He sees whatever he does, whatever he was operating in the earth, he sees according to the perspective of the Father or in the sight of the Father. He builds and establishes according to the mind of his Father. He cannot build anything apart because he can't see. He only can see the Father in his building. Are you all with me? So we can't build anything what we like. We must build according to how he sees who he is. So a dove's peculiar character, one, doesn't carry bitterness. Number two, it's a single focused, very focused on the Father's work. And that is why on the cross Jesus said, it is finished. Very focused. He gave an account to the heaven or account to the Father. That is finished. And I was just sharing with our guys a while ago. I say only 3 years of ministry Jesus completed it. How many years are you in Christ? நாங்கெல்லாம் 20 வருஷம் கிறிஸ்தவங்க நாங்க பார்க்காத மெசேஜா நாங்க கேட்க இந்த பிரசங்கலாம் நான் அப்பயோ கேட்டுட்டேன் வாய மூடுங்க 3 வருஷம் தான் மினிஸ்ட்ரி அண்ட் ஹி குட் சே ஆன் த கிராஸ் இட் இஸ் ஃபினிஷ்ட் நோ ஒன் எல்ஸ் குட் சே திஸ் வேர்ட் ரைட் ஆஃப்டர் தட் ஹூ ஸ்பெசிஃபிக்லி ஃபாலோட் த வேஸ் ஆஃப் ஜீசஸ் த கிரைஸ்ட் வாஸ் பால் நாட் த 12 டிசைபிள்ஸ் ஹூ வாக்ட் வித் ஜீசஸ் ஹி நெவர் ஈவன் ஹேவ் மெட் ஜீசஸ் Paul have not met Jesus. Who did he meet in Damascus? He did not meet Jesus. He met the Christ. Then he became blind. And Paul said, I've run a good race and I've finished it. Beautiful, man. So when Paul could do that, now I have hope. We say Jesus, wow, maybe Jesus is too much for me. But Paul, when Paul come and say, I'm useless, I'm worthless, what I know has become nothing comparing to knowing the mind of Christ. Paul said that. And that meant if he can finish everything, then I can finish too. I'm working towards that, to come and tell my Father, I've done my best to do all that you have taught me. I finished my race on the day of my passing on. I would tell that. I will definitely, God give me the strength to say this. And that will be in the record. And that's my journey. So, here you see the Spirit is coming and very focused. Single focused. What he says, and finish it. Within 3 years, Jesus finished it. We are still lingering. We are still trapped. We are having problem because we are all blind. So, number one, bitterness. Number two, focus. Third one, a faithful partner. When a dove become a pair, they are pair, if the partner passes on, they will remain single for the rest of their life and die. They will not mate with another. They stay away. And they live alone and they die. Can you see that? Faithfulness. Again, the singleness, faithfulness. Now, why these three things need to... Why John saw this Spirit ascending? It was a requirement on the Christ, on the Son of God. All of us are sons of God. The requirement, why? He was now, God has been placed in the earth. The world will hate you on my account. You can't carry bitterness, because if Jesus carried bitterness over anyone, then this person can never be redeemed. The people can never be redeemed. So whatever they do, Jesus must keep his heart pure and clean, not carry offense. Come on, people. We all carry offense. If right now, if you take out your gallbladder, you will see all the names of the people you hate or offended you, or you carry offense. Sometimes you are not angry with someone, you don't hate, but you're still keeping the offense of such people in you. And your behavior will... So when you carry offense, you can't. God cannot. The grace of God cannot operate through you to reach out to that person. So one of the key purpose of Jesus' key responsibility was not to carry offense. And the second one, he must become he must become the image of the unseen God. Very focused. Thirdly, faithful to the work God he received from the Father. He stays single, not because not getting married. The word single in the Bible, unmarried in the Bible, is not talking about your physical, natural marriage. Even after marriage, you need to be single with the Lord. You understand what I'm saying? No, you don't understand. So he said, I don't understand, Pastor. Even after marriage, every one of us must be still single to the Lord. That means my devotion, my journey, my purpose is still on to you, Lord. Even in this marriage, we, the couple, must be devoted to the callings of God, purpose of God. So I'm still single in my journey with God. I'm still focused on it. That means I don't have... After marriage, things will change. To me, no. Or without marriage, I'm still part of what God has sent me into the earth for. We are all are sent by God. None of us are here because we wanted to be here. Say amen. Correct or not? Then why are you here? Have you all ever asked? நிறைய தமிழ் படம் பாடலாம் இருக்கு. ஏன் பிறந்தேன், எதுக்கு பிறந்தேன்? இல்ல, யாருக்குமே தெரியாது. Nobody knows what's the purpose. So let me tell you why. You do not know because God sent you. That is why you don't know why you are here. Then if you want to know your purpose, you need to return back to him to find out, Lord, why. And then he will say, you are my representation. You are my body. You are who I am to the unseen, undeveloped world. The world will come to see who Papa is through you. That's your purpose. That's your purpose. Not to do ministry. Not to do great mission works. I'm not canceling all that. But all that at the own intent is only one. The world must come to know who the Father is. Today we do everything, but nobody knows who the Father is. You go enter a church, they know who's the pastor, they know who's the committee, they know what the church mandate, they know all the work of the church, they do not know the Father. People know the pastor, they don't know the Father. That's why I said this morning also, I share. You are not going to... What did I say? You're not going to the church. You're not supposed to be going to the church for something I say the purpose of you coming to the church is for the word. You got to labor in the word, not labor in the church. You can help this building to whatever sound, all that, cleaning up and food, all that. But you're coming to labor in the word, not in the church. Today, more people are laboring in the church, not in the word. You just walk by, some people are doing ushering, stand them. Can you please explain to me? I don't understand. Explain to me the word born again. That's how I know how a church is being developed. I enter any church anytime, not to test. I'm telling you because all of us are answerable to God. Many Christians come and can't even explain their salvation. Wrong. It's not doctrinal. It's not in the Bible. But churches are publicly saying this because ஒரு பொய்ய 10 வருஷமா சொல்லிருக்கனால பொய் இப்ப உண்மையா தெரியுது. Because when you start saying something again and again and you believe and believe, even a lie can become a truth to you. That is psychology. It's psycho your mind. That's our system that we are living in right now. Now the season of the Lord today now is bring the word of God. Break your mind. Break that setting. That's why just now we read in Romans, by daily renewing your mind. Okay? I'm afraid I might get distracted. I saw the Spirit descending from heaven like a dove. So the three nature. So the dove expresses the attribute of the Father and which ascended on a Son. Now, whenever you read this, it is about us. It's about us, not Jesus. Jesus is not the Son of God. Jesus is the prototype Son. We are the sons of God. You understand that? So God, the Father, is coming and showing us how we should be and how He will redeem us. So from heaven, from that vantage point, a set of attribute comes into the earth upon Jesus. But there's a reason why it upon Jesus. Jesus is the Word. The Word now, earlier for Jesus, you saw heaven, Spirit descended from heaven upon Jesus like a dove. Now, the Spirit of God and the attribute of the Father descends from the Word of God into a Son. Only for Jesus you see from heaven, but for us we see from the Word of God. So those who die in the Word of God, those who move into the Word of God, the nature and attribute of God will transfer and ascend from there to us because we are the sons of God. Understand? So, and remained upon Him. Why remained upon Him? He had to keep it because He's going to transfer it. For good, it came to us. All the attributes of God has been mandated to transfer into the body of Christ. Not Christian behavior. No Christian behavior. Christian behavior cannot reveal the nature and attribute of God. Christian behavior only introduces good. Good. Not righteousness. Righteousness is different from good. Good is not evil. Good is not enough. Righteousness belongs to my Father. So there are two types of Christians. You will meet people in the earth. One carry the goodness. One carry righteousness. The righteous people are not accepted. Good are well. So Christians choose to be good so that they can be accepted. They can multiply the church. You think bringing a lot of people to the church, you glorify God. Nonsense. Sorry to use. It's nonsense. Utter nonsense, not biblical. Jesus had only 12 disciples. So what do you want to say about that? He had only 12 disciples. You understand? So it's not about the numbers. It's about the lives being conformed or transformed into the image of Christ. If you have only 5 people and the 5 are living in Christ, that is the strongest church. Amen. Okay? That's how we are working. So I did not know Him. You see this word? Remain upon Him. I did not know Him. Who is saying this? John. But He who sent me to baptize with water said to me, upon whom you see the Spirit descending and remaining on Him, this is He who baptizes with the Holy Spirit. I explained this already, right? It's very powerful. Very powerful. Amen? Baptized with the Holy Spirit. And I have seen that and testified that this is the Son of God. Again, Son of God, you don't see a man, Jesus, with a long beard and standing at the beach. All the Christian movie, all the Jesus movie, all are messed up. Right? When you watch it, better be careful. Don't accept that picture. You got to see whenever Jesus, Son of God means a prototype model of you, for you and me, came into the earth. A model, a template came. You understand? Whenever I say Jesus, you must bracket, right? Word. Word. Capital letter W, capital letter O, R, D. So you, in the beginning was the word. It was, before the word, it was the voice. Before the voice, it was intent. Intent, unseen, imagination. Can anybody show me how your imagination would look like? Cannot. It doesn't have an image. So what was in the mind of God came to us in the form of a voice, and it need to now manifest in the form of the word, because our brain can only understand words. Came the word. So the word now manifested, and its form was, you look, it was Jesus. So its originality is not what you saw, what you haven't perceived yet. It's the word of God. Okay? So, I did not know him. You know who is this or not? Jesus' cousin. John the Baptist. Jesus, his own cousin, coming over there. He said, I did not know him. But he who sent me to baptize with water. He said, you see the word him is capital H? Right? He who sent me to baptize with water said to me, upon whom you see the Spirit descending and remaining on him, this is he who baptized with the Holy Spirit. I know from behind Joe is giving me signal, Pastor, please move. This one last week is done. But you must listen, because there's something here very powerful. John the Baptist is power only to baptize in water. He doesn't have the power to give you the baptism of the Holy Spirit. I already explained this to you. You must go back and listen. If you don't listen and follow the readings and the breaking of the word, the entire gospel will become a mess in your mind. It's already a mess. Now the Spirit of God is redeeming what actually he wanted to say through the breaking of the word in this place. Amen? So, and I have seen and testified that this is that prototype, that model. Idhudhaan. Heavenly vandhuchi, kaathukirundhom. Idhudhaan. Na witness pandra. Yaaru witness pandra? John's name? Grace. Grace of God. So what was declaring that this is that you have lost in the beginning, now it has ascended, this is that. What is declaring? The grace of God is declaring. You understand? It's not John. There was grace. John's name here is grace. An economy of the grace. So the grace of God now is now in the earth to give us back our sonship. What is the purpose of a grace? Only one reason. Enable your sonship in Christ. Give you back your birth certificate. Make you back the son in the house of God. Grace. Grace of God is not to do Christian works. Deva kirubinaala eppadiyo nanga ella vaandukittu irukkom. That's not the context. Naari pona context. Kartharude kiruba unga mele irukattum. Wrong. Wrong. Wrong administration. You go to your, where we go? Our ICA to get your birth certificates and all that, right? Now that place gives you your birth certificate, give you the right that authorize that you are the child of this person. And only they can do it. You cannot go to 7-Eleven to get an authorization certificate of your birth. Can you do it? Cannot. So the power of the Holy Spirit came into the earth in the form of the grace to give you back your rights to become a son of God. The purpose of grace is only one, to give you back your right. And grace has been abused, misused, and misunderstood because of undeveloped Christian mind. Amen. So do we need grace? Yes. Why? I need to return back to my Father. And only grace can give me that, because it's not easy to go back. Why? Before grace, and what do you compare grace with? Law. Law shows that I've lost the rights. Grace come and say, now there's a way for you to be a son. Follow me. Make sense or not? You don't have to look into so theologically, doctrinally, our Christian doctrines. You go to Bible school, they'll slap you with big and difficult words for you to understand God. My purpose is to break it to elementary level so you understand. Even children will grow. So, I have seen and testified that this. So, I have seen this is the grace. This is the grace of God. Seen and testified that this Son of God. From the Father's heart, the grace came and gave us the Son. Say, follow this. Amen? And again, the next day, John stood with two of his disciples and looking at Jesus as he walked. Whenever you see Jesus, what do you see? When you see what do you must see? Intent of God. The intent of God was walking in the earth. What was in the mind of God was walking in the earth. So you cannot just see a man, you must see the intent of God. That's how you read the Bible. You cannot just read what Jesus did. You must read Jesus first. What is Jesus and what was he? What is he doing, man? You must study that. So, again the next day, John stood with two of his disciples. And two of his disciples are also important because those who are following John only gave the baptism of the... Today, majority churches give you baptism of the water. They cannot give you revelation. You go to a church, you know the Bible, but no revelation. You have the word, no revelation. Today, 99% of churches can only give you the word with no revelation. Now, you must keep that in mind, right? So that's John's economy. Even John is waiting for Jesus to come so that the people can now benefit revelations. Revelation means what? Andore kathar varakudi naatkale ipdi seyapora apdi seyva va velipadu illa. Wrong. Okay, erase that. What are revelations? Whatever is in the mind of God for mankind, for earth, revealing that mind of God is a revelation to you. What? I have a plan. I call my team. I say I'm going to have a meeting. Ellarum unde kuda okkarga okkandralla eagle wait panna my mind la enna plan irukko na reveal panna poren, and so that they can understand and do according to it. Ivula dhaan your revelation. Adha vechi or periy ministry aarambichi kootam poi okkarranga kaasu kottranga. Revelation is free from God. It's not cheap. It's free from God to us, only to the sons of God. How do you receive revelation? Through grace. How you get grace? Through faith. How you get faith? Through breaking of the word of God. This is the process. So that your children will not fall into a religion called Christianity. It's an abomination.